MLM is not a numbers game. If it were, everybody who talked to a certain amount of people would be at the top ranks of their company. We know that it's not a numbers game. It's simply not true. It's a matter of getting your product and your opportunity in front of the perfect people that are already preconditioned to buy your product and to join your MLM opportunity. You want your business to be profitable, not just popular. It's about the amount of influence that you have, not the amount of likes and comments on your post. You do this by putting your product in front of those perfect people that are already preconditioned to buy it. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to know exactly who your target audience is. Secondly, I'm going to show you where to find those groups of people on Facebook. And lastly, I'm going to show you exactly what posts to have people reaching out to you for more information. What kind of groups were you involved with in high school? Or what kind of groups are your kids involved with in high school? I was a drama geek, a very proud drama geek. I loved to hang out with the choir kids and the kids in theater because that was my jam. We had the band geeks, we had the jocks, we had the cheerleaders, we had the people that were part of ASB. There were the people that liked to play chess. There was the video game group, all sorts of clubs in school that you could be part of, from cross country to mountain biking to the surfers that liked to go down at the beach. And these groups of people tended to hang out together. They'd go into these classrooms at lunch and hang out together as a club or a clique or a group. Why were you part of the clubs that you were part of? Why did you hang out with the friends that you hung out with? It's because you had things in common. You had common interests. There were things that you liked to do, which is why I was proud to be a drama geek. It was a badge of honor to me. It wasn't something negative. What did you call yourself in high school? What kind of groups were you part of? I want to know in the comments down below. These groups helped identify you as a person, and they gave you an identity as part of the group. The same thing happens when you're online. People tend to hang out together. Take a minute and write down really quick five things that you're really passionate about. Don't even think about it. Do you like to read books? Do you play an instrument? Do you love to watch sports? Is there a sport that you like to play? Are you a soccer mom? Are you a stay-at-home mom? Are you a school teacher? What's your profession? Write down some of the things that you like to do, some of the things that you're passionate about, some of the things that are your hobbies. What do you like to do on the weekend? What do you like to do for fun? Are you a big movie buff? Do you like to go down and play miniature golf? Do you like to take hikes? Do you like to jog? These are the things that make you unique, but they're also the things that make you just like other people. Just like you hung out with groups in high school and in college, there are those same groups online on Facebook. And the way that you find them is by going to the search bar. Go to the search bar at the top of Facebook and search some of the things that you're interested in. They can be hobbies and they can also be things that are more specific to your niche. I recommend doing a variety of both. Are you into beauty and makeup? Search for beauty and makeup. Do you love to play tennis? Search tennis. Are you into health and wellness? Search health and wellness. Do you love race cars? Search race cars. Do you like Legos? Are you a soccer mom? Are you into football? Do you have a specific team that you like to cheer for? You can search for all of those things on Facebook, and Facebook will show you exactly where those groups are. Once you've figured out where those groups are, identify three or four groups that you want to be a part of. Make sure that they're groups where people are actively posting and where people are actively commenting and engaging. You don't want to be part of a dead group, so make sure that they're an active group that's active right now. Jump down to the description and come join my Facebook group, where you're going to get a behind the scenes look at how I build my MLM, and you're going to get even more tips and tricks for building your MLM on social media. The first thing I'm going to let you know is what not to do in the groups when you get in there. Keep in mind that this is somebody else's group. It's kind of like going over to their house. How would a good guest act? What would a good guest do? That's how you want to act in somebody's group. You want to be a good member of this group. Do not post links about your product. Do not post links about your opportunity. You want people to reach out to you. You don't want to be the spammy spammer. First of all, that's just icky, salesy. It makes you weird. Nobody's going to join off of your link that you just throw up in that group. And secondly, which is even worse, this is your group of perfect people for your opportunity and for your company. There are people that are just like you. You have things in common. You have things to build a relationship around. If you go into these groups and post your link and tell them to come join your team, you're most likely going to get kicked out of this group. And now you no longer have a way to build a relationship with these new people that you don't know, these new people that are the perfect people for your MLM opportunity and for your products. So don't get kicked out of the group. Instead, what you want to do is to go into these groups and be the cheerleader. When someone's having success, congratulate them, cheer them on, be excited for them. When people are asking questions, find out the answer for them. Let them know how to deal with that problem. Find the solution with no other motive other than being able to be helpful and to be able to help this person in this group. As you do this, your profile picture is gonna start to pop up all over inside that group, and people are gonna start to identify you as the go-to expert that knows how to solve their problem. As that happens, they're gonna pop over to your profile to find out more about you. And since you've got a prime for profit profile, they're gonna naturally reach out to you to find out more information. Would you like more help coming up with your prime for profit profile? Click on the link in the description below to come and join the next round of the Social Media Blitz, where I'm gonna hold your hand to write the next 30 days of posts for your profile that's gonna lead to more leads that convert for your team and for your opportunity. Make sure that you like and subscribe so you don't miss any of the videos with tips and tricks on how to build your network marketing business on social media, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.